The Romans have arrived. Yes, they are here. And you can probably see by the title, do you know how many troops I have? I genuinely have no idea how this is running. But here we have 1,000 Roman soldiers. And you guessed it, this is a troop for every single video I have uploaded on this channel. I know, right? This is insane. I was just chilling out this morning thinking of what Bannerlord video to do today, and I noticed something. I noticed that on my dashboard, it mentioned that I had uploaded 999 videos, which means this is my 1000th video on the Resonant channel. And boy, is there no better way of doing it. Every single one of these Roman troops represents a video uploaded to my channel since I started it back in August of 2015. I think my first video was a North and South line battle video in September of the same year, and it has been a fun long ride. From the humble beginnings, just recording line battles with my friends, to be able to do this as a full-time job now while I try and make my way in the music industry as well. It is an incredible honor, and I can't thank you guys enough for being along with this journey. I mean, 1,000 videos. I don't think I've done 1,000 of anything in my life, let alone full videos that, yes, granted, when it started, wasn't really the same, but now take hours of recording, planning, and uploading to the channels and, you know, trying to find out things that you guys actually want to watch. 1,000 of those videos. It blows my mind that we've been here for that long. And yes, we haven't grown as fast as many channels on the site, because you can never really predict what's going to happen, especially when you do more niche content like I do. I mean, Mount & Blade isn't the most popular game, no matter what people want to tell you. You can see even more coming in at the back there. Oh my god, the amount of troops here. It is mad. Also, just the fact that Bannerlord can run this, might I add, this is running at the highest possible settings. If I just go back to my guy, at 4K, and I'm still getting about 60 FPS. That is mental. 1,000 troops. Let me just show you the settings, actually, just so you believe me. Very high. This is, everything's on the highest. The only thing I've turned off is the motion blur, because no one likes motion blur. But yep, everything's on the highest it can possibly be, and it's on well, my desktop resolution, which is 4K. Absolutely mental. It is absolutely mental. This game is incredibly optimized for what it is. What other game can you get this many troops on, doing this amount of detail and being in the battle? Yeah, Total War does something with more troops, but you're not this close in the battle, and the troops aren't this detailed. Also, this Roman mod, I have absolutely fallen in love with it. And here we are in a siege. I'm going to put this gameplay in the background just as I really go over the last 1,000 videos. As I said, we started off here, the first one in September-ish of 2015. There we were uploading just a line battle. I just kind of wanted to record the line battles I was doing with the clans. This was 8th US, I think was the name of the clan that I was in at the time, on North and South, which was the American Civil War mod. Now, I was leading some regiments in Napoleonic Wars, and March of Rome was a very popular mod. So popular, in fact, that it really introduced me to proper views on YouTube. It was the first time that I actually got some decent views. I mean, I remember my March of Rome videos getting like 10,000 views, and one of them like 100,000 views at this point. And that was all in the first few weeks of uploading. And I'd never seen those types of views. I was like, oh, maybe something could come of this. So I started doing some commentary videos. It started off with Mirror's Edge on my laptop. This was a £300 HP Pavilion that I saved up from doing my paper round with. And I recorded everything on there. It's terrible quality, I know. But it was fun, and it was something that I wanted to do. I'd never really thought about doing YouTube since I've been, you know, wanting to do music as a full-time career since I really started when I was about 5 or 6 years old. But YouTube was something I was enjoying. I was able to play games like Mount & Blade and put them on the internet and people would watch. Then I started doing the Persistent World series. Of course, the biggest ripoff. Everybody knows the Jam Patch channel, who really kind of pioneered those Persistent World story-based videos, and I was no different. I saw those videos and I thought, I'll have me some of that. So I started making them. And yeah, they got good views, so I carried on doing that and it went pretty well. But then I got a Steam message from a guy that ran the Mount & Blade 2 Bannerlord fan Steam group, saying, why don't you make some videos on Mount & Blade 2 Bannerlord and the upcoming developer blogs, and I'll share them on my Steam group. So I thought, hey, why not? And so I did, and my god, the views. People seemed to really like them, so I just kept doing them. Of course, I still did Warband modded videos and line battle videos when I wanted to, but Bannerlord developer blogs were really what people were coming to my channel for. And I think the rest sort of explains itself with the story of how my channel's been going. I love making videos on other games such as Total War sometimes, and things like Ancient Cities and Manor Lords, but Mount & Blade has really been the series that I really love, and that people on my channel, I think, really come to my channel for, and I'm going to carry on doing that as long as people continue to watch and enjoy my videos on the subject. And now that Manor Lord is out, granted in early access, I think it's great. I think we're starting to get some mods, and it's really picking up somewhat. You can tell by the amount of videos that I'm doing back on it. There was a space of like 3 or 4 months where, I kid you not, I just didn't load up the game. I didn't play Mount & Blade 2 Bannerlord, and you can actually see on my channel, I went and did other things. I talked about Ancient Cities, I went and talked about Medieval Dynasty, some Kingdom Come Deliverance stuff, and of course Manor Lords. But now Bannerlord has these cool mods, and now I think they're doing something really exciting with them. I'm back, and I'm going to continue making videos on all the mods and everything that you can expect within this game, because I know a lot of channels don't work well when they focus on one game. And I've never really focused on one game. Yeah, Bannerlord has been a big part of the channel and the last 1,000 videos, but if you look at the last 1,000 videos, I'd say like half the Mount & Blade Bannerlord videos. The rest are other stuff that I really enjoy talking about and looking into. But the thing is, because Mount & Blade and the games itself, and especially Bannerlord, is such a widely accessible game, there's so many mods and game modes and events and ways you can play the game, it's so self-sustaining. You can see Warman still has so many viewers even to this day, and I think it's going to be the same with Bannerlord. So I think there'll always be new content and new things to talk about in Bannerlord and the medieval community in general. You see, many genres and many types of games die off, but there's always a new medieval game, and there's always people that love history. You can tell whenever a medieval game comes out that's not been heard of but looks really cool. The community swells around it. You saw it with Medieval Dynasties, you saw it with Ancient Cities when that was announced. You've seen it with Manor Lords, the absolute insane buzz around that game. And I think this is a community that I absolutely love being in. And in a few more years' time, maybe I'll have 1,000 more videos continuing in the medieval community, talking about it and finding the best games to show off to you guys and the best mods in certain games like Bannerlord and Total War. But this brings me to my last few points. 1,000 videos on one YouTube channel is nothing to scoff at, and the only reason I've done it is because you guys enjoy watching my videos, and the amount of support that I've got from you guys is the reason that I carry on making videos like this. So if you guys keep watching them, I will keep bringing them. Also, in the new year, I have plans with a couple of my friends to start and grow a technology channel, as tech has always been something that I've been so interested in. Everything new and old and all the bits in between. Of course, there'll probably be announcements at the time, and I'm actually preparing a video now as a crossover video. I'm going to be building a computer that can run Mount & Blade 2 Bannerlord, but it's at the same price as a console. Since I've seen so many comments of people saying, why isn't it on console? I can't afford a PC that can run Bannerlord, but I'm going to prove you guys wrong. And I'm going to do it, and I'm going to upload it on this channel. But hopefully it will send some guys across to my technology channel once I have set that up. But what a pleasure it has been to make 1,000 videos on a YouTube channel that I had no intention of doing anything with other than a bit of fun. And now it has meant I've been able to get my own office, and I think I'm going to be able to get my own flat as soon as I leave uni next year. And that's all thanks to you guys. So thank you so much for watching. And to the next 1,000 videos, I will see you in the next one.